Oakwood Junior High. I have the honor and privilege today of interviewing Mr. Weckstein. He is here to answer a few questions about what it means to be resilient. Thank you for being here, Mr. Weckstein.
Absolutely. Thanks for including me. Mm-hmm. Hi, everybody.
So, Mr. Weckstein, first of all, do you mind just kind of updating us on how you guys are doing, what's been going on, how are your kids, et cetera, et cetera?
Absolutely. We've been doing pretty well, actually. The last month or so has been, I think, as good as it can be. As all of you know, I've been battling a pretty serious illness, so there's nothing that's fun about this, but I truly believe that I have been about as good as I could be most recently. My family is good. The kids, Colin and Casey, who are in fourth grade and second grade, they've been truly fantastic. We try to stay as positive as we can with everything, and I think that has rubbed off on the kids. So thank you for asking about the family and about me, and I truly believe we're doing all right.
Cool. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now, for today's topic, it's resilience. And so just to give us a little background, can you talk about what's been going on the past year, and then kind of tie that in to being resilient? How are you resilient through all of this, and who's important in being resilient in your life?
Okay. Those are a lot of questions, Mr. Connolly. I'll do my best to answer all of them. So over the past year, as all of you most of you know, back in June, I ran into some very, very serious medical concerns. It turns out that I have stage 4 brain cancer, which is very, very serious. And it's not something that you can, in my opinion, sit back and say, woe is me. Otherwise, it will be, I believe, worse for you, worse for the family, worse for the people around you. So when I found out that I do indeed have cancer, it was tough to hear. It was very tough to hear. But my wife and I intentionally stay as positive as we can. We talk about it quite a bit. As you probably know, my wife writes about it on a Caring Bridge blog. We are as positive as can be for us. We are as positive as can be for the kids. And we are as positive as can be for all of those around us. But it's been a tough now 7 months. It's been very challenging. And we stay positive. We stay resilient because of our attitude. We focus on the things that we can control. I can't control that I have or have not cancer. I have it. There's nothing that I can do about it beyond what the doctors are telling me to get rid of it. We fight it. And we fight it hard, and we're in good care. But there are things that we truly can control. We can control our attitude. We can control how we act around others, how we act when we're by ourselves. And that's how we stay resilient. That's how we stay positive.
That's awesome. So to go along with all this, who in your life plays a really big role in you being resilient particularly?
Great question, and there are so many people that play a role in that. The biggest factors are my kids. I feel it's so important that I am positive and resilient as a role model for my own children, Colin and Casey. But they aren't the only ones. My wife, Kelly, is a huge piece in that. She helps me be resilient, and I believe that I help her be resilient the same way that I help my kids. But there are so many other people as well. My close friends, the teachers at the junior high school, and so many of them are my close friends. But you know, all of you, the students of Oakwood Junior High School, the community of Oakwood Junior, of Oakwood City, so many people have played a major, major role in helping me get through this. Helping me be resilient, helping me see the positive in all of this. You think, how can there be positive in all of this? Well, living in Oakwood, being around so many awesome people makes it so easy to see the light, to see the light at the end of the tunnel, to understand that life goes on, and live it as positively as you can.
Wow, those are some awesome things. So in light of all that, Mr. Weckstein, I think with resilience being the focus for Take 5 this week, what I really want is, based upon all this, what would you give the students as advice for being resilient, based upon what you just said?
Another great question, Mr. Connolly. And you know, I want to start this answer by saying, I'm not the expert in resilience. Certainly I have had a very unfortunate experience over the past half a year. So I've got some experience with resilience, and working with so many great people over the past over 20 years, I've seen a lot of things. But I'm not the expert. I can share my story. And based on my story, I certainly have some advice. And I think the best piece of advice I would give is, think about who your people are that you would go to in the event that you run into a problem. Because unfortunately, throughout your life, you will run into a problem. And hopefully it's never as serious as what I've got going on right now. But there are problems you will run into. Maybe now it's you get a bad grade on a test. Maybe now it's you and a friend or a boyfriend, girlfriend have a fight. You know, these are all problems. Who do you go to when you have this kind of problem? Think about that now. Think of a list of at least three people that you would go to when you run into a problem. Maybe it's a parent. Maybe it's a teacher. Maybe it's a close friend. Maybe it's a priest or a rabbi or someone like that. But think about this now so you don't have to think about it when you're under crisis. Because when you're stressed, then it's hard to think straight. The other piece of advice I would give is, when you are stressed, when you do run into conflict, try to take a step back and think about, okay, this has happened, or this is my problem. What of this can I control? What of this can I do? Can I change? Can I adjust to get through this, to make this positive? And it's hard. It's hard to make things positive sometimes, but it can be done. Don't dwell on what worries you or what upsets you. Think more about what you can do to get out of this problem. And those people that are on your short list of who to go to, let them help you. Because guys, I'm telling you, if I had tried to do this on my own, and I have the kind of personality that I like to do things, I like to solve problems on my own sometimes. If I tried to solve this problem on my own, I couldn't have done that. I couldn't be this positive about what's going on. I needed the help of my family. I needed the help of the teachers at the junior high. I needed the help of the entire community of Oakwood and more. Let people help you. Know who those few people are so that you can go to them and let them help you. That's the advice that I would give.
That's some intense advice, Mr. Weckstein, but it's awesome. Thank you so much for doing this.
Absolutely. I wish I could be back at school. I can't tell you how much I miss all of you, the teachers, the students, the parents, but just the day-to-day life at work. I've been in education for 21 years, and I miss it very, very much. I miss being there, and I wish I could be there, and I hope to be able to be back very, very soon. Thank you for letting me participate in this. I I'm so glad that you emailed me to ask to participate, so thank you.